Do you want to create cool-looking, color-changing texts in Pygame? Then you've come to the right place. My name's Adrian, welcome to my channel. This is the first tutorial video made by me. If you watched some gameplay of Orcslayer, you've already seen this feature. If not, it's worth your time. But for now, let's get into the tutorial. First, let's create a simple, responsive window. If you know the basics, you can skip ahead. Here are the things we need to do. Import Pygame, set the window size, create our display and screen that we draw onto, and set the clock. Then we have to initialize Pygame, also create a loop with the run boolean. Within the loop, we check for the quit event. This sets the run to false and closes the window. Then we update the clock and bleed everything on the screen. Now comes the fun part. We need to add two basic colors. You can define colors in Pygame as a triplet of numbers ranging from 0 to 255. These are the intensities of the red, green and blue colors. 0 means no intensity, 255 means maximum intensity, so 000 is black, and 3 times 255 is white. Next, we create a text drawing function. What you need to pass as arguments are the string that you want to draw, the size of it, the color and the coordinates. You can use a specific font type that's in the scripts folder, or you can use the default one. I will use my own font now. First, you set the size of your font, then you create a surface with the text string and the color. After that, you make a rectangle for your text surface with the given coordinates, and lastly, you draw it onto the screen with the bleed function. Of course, you have to call this function in the main loop of the script. Then we can create two types of color change. First one is flashing. We need color speed and direction variables for that, and a default color list that's values are going to change. The direction values can be 1 to increase the intensity, -1 to decrease it, and 0 to leave it unchanged. Now let's create the function. It will need the color and direction as the arguments. For every element in the color list, it will add the color speed times the direction to them every cycle of the code. To avoid crashing, we need to set some conditions, like if the value reaches maximum, it drops down to 0, and if it reaches 0, it goes back up to 255. This is what creates the flashing effect. Side note, the text won't be transparent. If you want to do something like that, you have to play with the alpha value. We can call it now in the main loop, and you can see that it's getting brighter and then goes back to black again. If you set the values like this, it will go the other way around. Of course, you can narrow down the interval by setting a specific minimum and maximum value like so. Now we can move on to the breathing effect. What creates this effect is that when we reach maximum and minimum value, we reverse the direction of the intensity change and not start over from 0 or 255. We have to create a color changing function like so. You can see that when the color value reaches minimum or maximum, the corresponding direction value is multiplied by -1. So if it was 1 and increasing, upon reaching maximum, it changes to -1 and decreasing. Now we can call this function. Of course, we can create multiple lines of text this way. We can define a lot of colors and directions to play with the effect. Here's a simple example showing you 3 different rows with a green effect. If you want to spare some time and leave the typing to a function, You can create arrays from these lists and strings, so it will only take one call to create all these texts and update the colors. The new list of colors should include all the sublists of RGB values, same for directions. You need a list for the strings as well. Now we can make the helper function. It will go through all the elements of the new lists, then it calls the already made text drawing and color changing functions. What you need as the arguments are the color list, the direction list, the text list, the size and the coordinates. To bleed these strings below each other, we can add some number to the Y value every new cycle. After this, we can call this new helper function. Now with this function, you can create as many rows as you want. Here's a quick example with 6 rows. Now at the end of the video, I want to show you some different examples that you can achieve by getting creative with the RGB and direction combinations. The first one is what I call synced colors. Don't ask me, it just looks appealing. The second one is the same but with greater minimum, so it appears more pale. The next one has its colors a bit randomized. This one reminds me of a heartbeat. Here's a red and blue example. And last but not least, a breathing green one. And that's it. Now you can create your own cool looking text in Pygame. If you found this useful, please leave a like and subscribe to see more stuff like this. If something is not clear or you have a question, be sure to leave a comment. Thanks for watching and have a nice day. Take care.